Hi, I'm Phil Greenberg. I'm currently the president of the American Association for Cancer Research. My research has largely focused on immunology. How does the immune system interact with cancer or fail to interact with cancer? And then ultimately, how can we modulate the immune system so that it has more productive interactions with cancer, ultimately to try to promote eradicating cancers? The progress in cancer research, particularly in the last two decades, has literally been breathtaking. When I started in the field, we treated cancers with what people might call a sledgehammer approach, to an era now where we have drugs that very precisely target the abnormality that's present in a patient's tumor cell. And it's really introduced what people would now call the era of precision oncology. Virtually all of the advances we've seen have evolved from studies in basic science that were not necessarily intended when they started to identify a new cancer therapy, but were to really understand the way biology works. All of these advances are coming together to really advance the therapies and to make them increasingly precise and decreasingly toxic so we can really improve the quality of life of patients. So I think there's virtually no question but that we are going to need advances in basic science in areas we can't predict will be important to actually fuel the next generation of advances. We recognize that cancer research is expensive. We really are incredibly grateful that people have provided resources for us to be able to pursue cancer research. The return on investment has been absolutely enormous. For example, in the decade from 2010 to 2019, there were 356 drugs approved by the FDA that have changed the way diseases are treated. 354 of those 356 were supported by NIH research dollars. And in the last 40 years, there's been 14 million years of additional life because of the advances in cancer research. That's a lot of people who have lived longer, who have been at the dinner table for a much longer time with their families because of advances in cancer research. The deaths in pediatric patients from cancer have declined by 70% from 1970 to 2020. That's an incredible achievement. It does not negate the fact that there is much, much more work to be done, but it does highlight really how much has been accomplished and how much is being accomplished. We have seen that the death rate has declined 33% in the last several decades and is continuing to decline, and it's in virtually all cancers. We are in a time of unparalleled opportunities in cancer research because of the technological explosions and advances that have been made. And not increasing that investment will result in a loss of the momentum that's actually been created. So we have developed an incredibly talented, creative, young workforce now in cancer research that is driving new ideas, new technologies. And if dollars for research diminish, these people will very rapidly recognize that there is not really a viable career for them. And losing that population of people will not only diminish the quality of science and the creativity of science that we're doing now, but it will impact science progress for decades because you can't replace people once you lose them. And so this is the time to really take advantage of putting all of these advances together. We see no reason why the cancer death rate can't continue to decline and decline potentially at a higher rate. But all of that is going to take commitment by cancer researchers and commitment by the government and the community in investing in supporting cancer research. This is really a time when increasing that investment would have enormous impact.